My name is Winnie Job. I'm a member of the Johannesburg Heritage Foundation, previously known as Parktown and Westcliff Heritage Trust. I am a historic tour guide. My main concern is that this land should be developed as it is a cemetery, and as a cemetery it is consecrated ground, and there are lots of things to go through before you can use ground that has previously been a cemetery. How are they going to trace the people who are here? Because most of them were itinerant miners who came from the various migrant miners who came from all the surrounding countries. And it's a very old cemetery. EOPM mine was about 1897, 98. So it's a very old mine, very old cemetery. How are you going to find the people who these remains belong to? And you cannot leave the remains in the ground. They must be moved and properly reburied with dignity. There's no sign here of any numbers or identification of the graves, except right at the very far back of the cemetery, where there are still some headstones, engraved headstones, which unfortunately have been desecrated. They have been broken. My main objection here is I would like to see that the men who are buried here are treated with dignity, because they left their families. They came to work in the gold mines. They left their families. They unfortunately died of various reasons, probably illness or accidents. And you can't just develop the ground and say they didn't exist. It has to be done with dignity. And to do that, the developers must be made fully aware. Whoever buys this ground, if it is eventually sold, it has to be done in accordance with the strictest rules laid down by the laws of removing remains from the ground and reburying them. You can't just say, well, we'll dig it up and that's it. Who knows who they were? We don't know who they were. We probably never will know who they were. But they were still men who came here and they lost their lives here. And they need to be buried where they can be respected. Who knows, apart from a few people, that this was a cemetery? And if the remains do get moved, I feel that they should be done with dignity, and it should be noted that these are the remains of the men from the mine. I don't know who the mine sold the ground to eventually, originally, or even if they did. I have no idea, but the mine is now closed, as far as I know. But they must have some sort of record somewhere of people who were buried in the cemetery. You can't just throw them away.